fui siendo un soldado, regresé siendo un delincuente.
Hacemos lo que queremos, cuando y cómo queremos.
¡El dinero!
No quiero ser un gánster. Hace mucho que dejé de pensar en ellos.
Ya no importa lo que tú quieras. Esta es tu vida.
Ben, your character Joe Coughlin says that he's tired of following orders. Does that apply to yourself and the projects you work on, especially when you sign them as writer, director, actor, makeup artist?
Well, you know, that's part of the responsibility of being the boss, I guess, for lack of a better word, is that, you know, you don't have to follow orders, but you have to take a lot of the responsibility, and that's the trade-off. Mm-hmm. And I think, you know, his disillusionment with the First World War, you know, put him in a place where he sort of resented authority figures in general. I don't have any of those kinds of issues personally.
Sure. And Sienna, in a movie like this where there's a great majority of masculine characters, strong female characters are very important, like yours or Elle Fanning's, for example. And how does this relate to current Hollywood's situation?
You know, I think there's definitely a movement towards more female-driven films. I notice it in the scripts that I'm reading. I think one of the pulls of this film for Ben was that there were three strong female characters, mm-hmm. and that's so rare. You never read that. I was looking at some of the posters around this year, and there's Amy Adams, who's the face on a poster, and Jennifer Lawrence, the face on her poster, and I feel like that wouldn't have happened a couple of years ago. So there is a movement in the right direction, but we still have a way to go.
And in this film, for both of you, we've got Cubans, Italians, Irish, everything. And you even, in a scene, seem to refer directly to a very important political figure of the moment. And how does this film reflect the current socio-political situation?
Well, the film deals with, you know, immigration and assimilation and racial prejudice and the ways that can be work in overt and also kind of tacit ways. It's the original sin of the United States, but part of our glory is that we're a nation of immigrants, and it's also mm-hmm. been an ongoing source of conflict and struggle. There's a sort of curious phenomenon that happens with immigrants where as soon as they get in, you know, they want to close the door on the guy behind them. And so oftentimes some of the most prejudiced people are the newest members of the group. It's but in this case, it's really about the white Protestant power structure, the patrician American power structure that is resisting the encroachment of immigrants. And I guess we don't have to look very far to see that today.
Mm-hmm. And what do you think about that?
I think that the film is alarmingly current. The fact that we're having the same conversations now as people were having 100 years ago. I think the world is in this strange anti-globalization phase with Brexit and the election in America. You know, we're in a really pivotal time, and I think we have to really be, I feel like our generation is more politicized than it ever was before. There's something beautiful in that, but I am, it's alarming.
And Ben, would you prioritize your own projects like this one over other commitments you may have?
You know, I feel if you take on the responsibility of a film, you have that responsibility no matter what, and they're all equally important. Anything that you're gonna put your time to has to make just as important as everything else.
Esto es el paraíso. Justo esto. Donde nos encontramos.
I knew that something would always rule.
Pasas la vida esperando a ser castigado por tus pecados. Y aquí me tienes.